Hi everyone, and welcome to today's green screen activity. I'm really excited about today's activity, which was designed for the late talker or early intervention group. So these are young kiddos who are either nonverbal and are just beginning their path to verbal communication, or kids who we want to teach the foundations of communication, so teaching eye contact, turn taking, copying actions and gestures, being noisy and being loud and being silly and using their voices for communication. Of course, we can always get in there copying gestures and actions and signs and word approximations and single words and two-word phrases, you name it, we can target it. So this is an activity I do a lot with kiddos, whether we're in person or whether it's online or whether it's coaching a family about how to use this activity at home. This one is a fan favorite for me particularly, and I think it's a lot of fun for kids as well. So there's two ways to do this. So one is the online version. So if you're in a therapy session, you can use this with a child if you're the clinician. If you're a family member, you can get your physical objects and play along. You don't need the same objects that are here, it can be any object. If you have matching objects, that's great. If not, you can use your own. So there are lots of options for this activity. We can play a digital version, we can play a physical version, or we can do both at the same time. And this is a great activity for families and caregivers to take and use right away, right after the therapy session is over, using it at home, during play, in the bath, anywhere. So this activity is called Up on the Wall, and what we do in this activity is we take a physical toy, or we're going to take a digital toy, and we're going to put it up, up, up on the wall. Ready, set, go. Let it fall. So you get a really good vocalization there. You can let the toy fall. Hopefully they're soft toys. Hopefully it's not gonna, you know, hurt your hardwood or whatever. It should be something that's really fun and you get a reward. You get a crash sound at the end. So you can do that with physical objects at home. Now, I chanted those lyrics, which you can do at home. Up, up, up on the wall. Ready, set, go. Let it fall. You can also change it to up, up, up. Pig on wall, ready, set, go, let it fall, so that you're actually getting the object name in there. Now, I really like the rhythm and I really like the simplicity of the lyrics. It's really good vocabulary for these late talkers and for early intervention because we're hitting a lot of different kind of words. We're getting spatial words, up, 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 and on. Ready, set, go is a nice verbal routine. Let pig, you get the noun in there, and fall. It's a really great action word, and you can do crash at the end, or wee, or wow, or uh-oh, lots of different things that you can do. So I think that the lyrics are really great for this activity, along with a really fun task of dropping objects. Now, what I would do with the online version is to go through the list of objects here and talk about what do you see? Car, binky, or nummy, or pacifier, or soother, or sucker, whatever you might say. Bus, ball, block, duck, dinosaur, teddy, boat, train. Lots of good vocabulary in there. Also great vocabulary for making non-speech sounds, so things like vroom, vroom, or beep, beep, or choo-choo, or quack, quack, quack. Lots of different fun vocalizations and ways to be noisy with this vocabulary before you even get to the activity. So the next step would be to try and cue the child to, let's do the car. Should we drop the car? Would that be so silly? So we could take the car and cue the child to help us move it over. Show me moving over. You show me. So we're getting a copying action in there. So you can do things like ready, set, over. Wow, look at our car. Vroom, vroom, beep, beep. Now, once we have our object here, we might want to model that rhyme or that little poem so that the child can hear it. So we might model the first one ourselves. Up, 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 on the wall, ready, set, go, let it fall. Crash, oh no, it fell down. Do you want to try? You can send a list to parents ahead of time to see if they have some of these matching objects. So if a child has that object, you might want to go through it again and see if they can copy your actions and gestures. So then you might go from the beginning. You show me your truck. Ready? Let's do it. You show me. And then you can go through it again. Now, if your client or your child is like the many clients that I see, they love songs. So my favorite thing to do is to actually take that chant and put it to a song, and the song goes like this. Up, 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 truck on wall, ready, set, go, let it fall, crash, oh no. And if they had their truck, they would get to do it as well. Now, a fun way to get rid of the toy is to push or move or say, it's all done. Let's do another one. Let's do it again. Let's put away, away, away. Or if the parent has a bin nearby, you can put the truck away or in, and then we can do it again. Sam will push the truck away. Can you help me push? Good helping. Okay, let's do another one. I see ball. You can model that sound and model the word and see if they'll copy you. And again, this whole activity is designed to be one big verbal routine. So you're doing the same thing in the same way every time. So you're taking the ball, show me over. Remember what we did? Over. Good job, you moved the ball over. By the time you've gone through all of the toys, the child should recognize the rhyme or the song, and you can teach the parents so that they can do this activity at home. So you can go through again. Up, 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 ball on wall, ready, set, go, let ball fall, crash, oh no, bounce, bounce, oh, ball bounced. Do you have a ball? You show me bounce, bounce, bounce. So again, we have the digital image, we have a physical image. You can pair the two, you can just focus on one or the other. A great activity to use in a therapy session and at home. Now again, to get rid of the toy, Miss Sam is going to push, so the child can help me with the action there, as I push the toy by. Or if the child has the physical object at home, you can cue the parent to help them put the toy in the box. We're all done with the ball, bye ball. And then you can go on to the next object. So again, you can introduce the vocabulary items in different ways. So the next one is the teddy bear. Hi, teddy bear. Let's give teddy bear a hug. Hug. So you can do different actions, different social scripts with each object, but then you get to the same point in the same part of the activity where it's now expected that the child's gonna help you move the toy over. Now, as you do this, by the seventh toy, you might want to start to pause to let the child fill in their own part. So you might go, Teddy, Teddy, let's go. Ready? Should we sing? Should we do a song? Ready? Let's drop Teddy. Up, up. And see if the child will fill in up. They don't need to sing it, but they might fill in up if you look at them expectantly. Bear on. Bear on. What's he on? Bear on wall. Ready, set. You tell me. Go. Let bear. And then they might want to fill in fall, fall, crash, crash. Oh no. And then they might copy your action or your gesture or a ksh sound. Or you can clap afterwards. Lots of different points to stop in the song and leave a pause for a child to copy a gesture, copy an action, copy a vocalization, whatever. And if they're doing something new with the toy, you copy them so that you're teaching them that imitation is fun and we want to do this and we like copying each other. And that is the foundation for communication. So have fun going through all of your objects, singing the song that I created up on the wall to move the objects up and let them fall and have such a fun time with it in speech therapy and at home. I hope you guys really enjoy using this activity at home with your little ones.